Good morning, children. Welcome back to English class. We have completed our first unit, but you did not have books, no? That's right. We are not starting now the workbook part. When you buy books, we will start the workbook part. Now let us go to the second unit. So our second unit, first lesson is Sir C.V. Raman, the pride of India. C.V. Raman, the pride of India. Who is C.V. Raman? A scientist. You know that he is a scientist. Let us see some other scientists, names of some other scientists, which you have the picture in your textbook. So see that pictures in your textbook. First one is APJ Abdul Kalam. APJ Abdul Kalam. What did he invent? He invented the missile technology. Missile technology. Next, Sir C.V. Raman. He invented Raman effect. So, is about him only now our lesson. So, next, Srinivasa Ramanujan. So, he was deal with the numbers, created the numbers. Next, Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein. He just invented the definition. That means this one, E is equal to MC square. That's why he proved this E is equal to MC square. So, that he was made as father of modern physics. Was called as father of modern physics. Next, Isaac Newton. So he just found the law of gravitation. So he was the first one who found that the earth has a gravitational attraction. Next, Thomas Alva Edison. He invented the electric bulb. So see, by seeing all those, so what do you do? What do you want to become in your life? Some of you may think, you may say that I want to become a scientist, and many of you, if you are, even though you are not interested in subject, you are interested in making things such a way. So scientists never do great things. They do small things in a great way. They do small things only in a great way. So we need not to underestimate any student, even though he is average in studies. May become a scientist if he has such an interest. So these are the examples of some scientists. Now let us see about our scientist and who are given in our lesson. Who was given in our lesson? Sir C.V. Raman. C.V. Raman. Full name of C.V. Raman is Chandrasekara Venkat Raman. The pride of India. So we should be proud to be that he is a belongs to our country. He is an Indian. And when was he born? He was born on 7th November 1888. He was born in Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. He was born in Tiruchirappalli in Tamil Nadu. And what was his father? His father was a college science lecturer, physics lecturer. College physics teacher was given. So his father was a physics teacher. Actually, when he was studying, he completed his matriculation. He was very much interested in science. He has completed his matriculation. Matriculation means in those days. So we used to call that 10th class, equivalent to 10th class. Matriculation, SSLC in such a way, they used to give separate names for that. So that is equal to a 10th class. After that, his parents were interested to send him to abroad. Abroad means to other foreign countries. Abroad means foreign countries. But according to some health issues, one of the surgeon advised him to stay back in the country only. So he could not go anywhere. So he studied only in India. So after that, he completed his MA from Presidency College, Chennai. Now we call Chennai. Previously it used to be called as Madras. So MA, he has finished his MA in Presidency College, Madras. And at the age of 19, he became the member of IACS. IACS means Indian Association for Cultivation of Science. Indian Association of Cultivation of Science. At the age of 19 years, very young age only, he became the member of this because he has such an interest in science. Now, so in the starting of the lesson, he was in the building. It was in a busy bustle of a road in Kolkata. There was an old building, that is ISES building, and there was an excitement. There was a hot topic everywhere. All the scientists were discussing. So what happened on the day? Compton effect. Compton effect. When C.V. Raman was in his lab and he was showing his equipment. In the lab, equipment will be there, no? So he was showing his equipment to some visitor. When visitor came to his lab, so he was showing him those material. And Krishnan, a young man, came under, "Sir, Professor Compton, Professor Compton won Nobel Prize." So everyone really felt very happy. And Professor Compton won the Nobel Prize. He worked on X-rays. So what is this effect? That is Compton effect. What does it mean? When X-rays pass through the substance, it changes through the matter. It changes its shape or its origin. That means it depends upon the matter it goes through. That means when it goes through the liquid, or when it goes through the transparent place, or when it goes through the any other solid. So it changes its origin. So it is the effect of Compton. That was so far this. He won the Nobel Prize. Everyone was very happy. A.H. Compton, he worked very hard for that. And along with them, C.V. Raman was also very happy. So equally delighted. He was lost in thought. Means something he was thinking. Suddenly he said that, "Krishna, if Compton's effect is true and it was proved, and why doesn't it was proved for X-rays, why doesn't it prove for light rays? Because the effect of Compton was proved. Everyone agreed that, and he was given Nobel Prize. Nobel Prize also. So, and C.V. Raman also working on the same one, that is light rays, but the same procedure. So why can't it be true?" he said. So as soon as that, he started doing that. He was working on that for 3 years in his lab. And in his lab, in the sense, do you think that there is a costly, expensive equipment? No such a sophisticated equipment. Sophisticated means ultra modern. No such equipment. Only the equipment which is worth of 200 rupees. Worth of 200 rupees. So he was working with the same equipment. And after that, at the end of March, he started telling. Actually, February 28th. And February 28th only, he just found it. That means invented it. But on March 16th, he said it to the world. He announced it to the world. And really, the world, everyone looked at India, because it's a really great invention. So for that, everyone paid their attention towards India. So on Raman, C.V. Raman. So it's a really a great invention, and everyone appreciated. And for that, he got a Nobel Prize in 1930. In 1930, he won the Nobel Prize. So, whereas he found that means invented that on February 28th, that day was only we are celebrating as National Science Day. And how was this? He used to work very hard for that. Only equipment is less. But after his studies, after his MA, he did not go to the science lab, and then he did not work on the science. But on the wish of his parents, to give respect to his parents, he took in the finance ministry an administration job. An administration job in the finance ministry. But so he has very much interested in science. So what did he do? In the evenings, after coming back from the office, he used to go to lab and spend there the whole night. The whole night he used to spend there. So, and he especially interested and worked on echo sticks. साइंस ऑफ सॉन्ग्स एकोस्टिक्स एकोस्टिक्स सो लाइक स्ट्रिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स वीणा लाइक सो स्ट्रिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट व्हेन वी मूव द स्ट्रिंग्स स्ट्रिंग्स व्हेन वी मूव द स्ट्रिंग्स दे विल गिव हार्मोनियस प्लेजेंट दैट मींस प्लेजेंट सॉन्ग्स सो ही वर्क्ड ऑन इट हाउ कुड दे गिव सच ए different when we move in such a way the strings how could they give different sounds so he worked on that very much and he was elected as a knight as a knight 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 that means a royal person a great person by the royal society of london in 1924 by the royal society of london in 1924 And by the British Empire in 1929, and he was not even prized in India, even though he belongs to India. He was not only prized in India. He completely studied in India, but he won the Nobel Prize. And he was the first person who studied wholly in India and won the Nobel Prize. He was the first person, and he was the first Asian who. And a non-white person who won the Nobel Prize also. So he created a world record. So Indians, we respect him, but he was respected by the Royal Society of London and British Empire, everyone. So he worked in such a, and to the world, he was telling, don't confine yourself to the young scientist, everyone he was suggesting. Don't confine yourself. To the laboratories, come to the outside world. It depends on your hard work and new ideas, thoughts. But it doesn't depend on equipment. Equipment doesn't matter. So how much did he expend on the equipment? 200 rupees. Only 200 rupees. That much only he expended on that. He spent on his equipment. So he was suggesting the all other scientists also in the same way. No need to buy latest or expensive equipment, but so we need to work hard wherever we have. We need to think better and work hard. And finally, he expired. That means died, passed away on 1970, 21st November. But even though he died, so he is in our heart. We'll never forget him because of the Raman effect. Raman effect. And we celebrate every year National Science Day on 28th February. We celebrate in our school also, no? So that's it. Why do we celebrate this? So because on that day only, C.V. Raman invented his Raman effect. Raman effect on light rays. How light rays, when they pass through the different object, that means when they pass through the liquid, when they pass through the different object, how do they change their shape or their origin? So that is his invention. So we should really, he is the pride of India. We should really feel proud of such an Indian, such a scientist. Okay, children. So that's the end of the lesson. Read the lesson in the textbook. Thank you.